Maru Regmi and Yuvraj Pokhrel aren't related, but they're like siblings. The pair is part of a family of thousands raised by not-for-profit anti-slavery organisation Mighty Nepal.
I landed there when I was just 1 month old. I feel like Mighty Nepal has been my family ever since. I don't know what is like a, you know, single family or a nuclear family.
Maru and Yuvraj weren't trafficked, but their paths have been shaped by the children and women they grew up with in Nepal who survived slavery.
I closely witnessed those kind of situations with my eyes. So I experienced the stories of the women, how they were treated in the brothels, how they were treated in the workplace, in their workplace, when they got trafficked.
This is building one.
The two are now in Australia, studying for a Master's in Business Administration at Charles Darwin University, gathering skills they'll use to fight human trafficking.
It is a very big issue in Nepal, and not just trafficking overseas now. With the post-COVID era, trafficking within a country, domestic trafficking has also been a very severe problem in Nepal.
The founder of Mighty Nepal says drivers of trafficking include poor access to education and jobs, a gender disparity in Nepal, and the open border with India, which gives important access to shipping routes.
We train children, we have prevention homes, we train girls because of no job opportunity also, they are trafficked. So we train them in different skills and then we give them jobs.
Human trafficking is a global issue, with the United Nations suggesting one in three victims are children. A 2024 report estimates the profits for modern slavery at $236 billion, an increase of 35% over 10 years. More than 50 million people are affected.
The numbers globally are horrifying, and we know that there are children exploited in global supply chains, in mines, extracting minerals that are used in our phones, working in food industries, in clothing and so on around the world.
Madhu and Yuvraj hope their studies will give them the tools to make a difference. Letitia Lemke, SBS World News.